not even here. Who cares? Moving on. Nairo versus Mars. What a classic, man. We got the old, like, student against master. You know, I love that, man. Yeah. You know they both have so much respect for each other. But right now, Nairo, no respect for the Zero Suit. Cutting him off in the air. All over the place. That might be a stock. A zero to death from Nairo.
There
to
are
open
no
up
friends
the stream.
In war.
Oh, my goodness. And then he's using the platform. Nairo, he's got hit yet. Mars, come on, man. There he goes. Okay. He's ready. He's getting his foot in the door now.
And you would think that history is just going to favor Nairo here because he knows the ins and outs of Zero Suit Samus on an intimate level, right? He's played this character for years. He still dabbles in Ultimate. Of course, you're probably not going to see it in tournament, but on stream, he plays a good bit of everybody. But man, Mars catching such a hit to the face on that first stock, man. Didn't even lay a scratch.
So to start it off, it's definitely looking like a dogfight. A lot of air-to-air combat, both trying to stuff each other out. Both trying to beat each other to the punch in the air, and Nairo's been getting the better end of it, getting another nair here, looking for an up air, looking for a high recovery, probably the flip jump kick, or the flip jump, no kick.
Ooh, the auto reticle from just outside of that plasma whip range. Mars unable to get the second hit. That big, of course, he's only at 72. I was looking at the wrong percent. Why
is this
guy?
Okay, good tech away from Mars. Smart stuff from Nairo. It's the air dodge there. Mars trying to cover the ledge here, trying to catch on to some habits from Nairo. Unable to find the move. Nairo playing immaculately right now. Stuffed into the ground. How's your mashing? Not good enough. Mars going to catch him with the up B on the other side. Easy KO on Smashville. Zero Suit Samus. But, oh, that was amazing placement, but Zero Suit skinny as a pencil, just weaving around that naturally. But Nairo on the other side saying, I'm keeping the stock lead, buddy.
Yeah, tall as she may be, it is sometimes difficult to hit her just because of how she contorts when she's in hit stun. All right, Nairo policing this edge right now, not letting Mars through at all.
Nair out of shield too slow, yeah.
Yeah, Mars is going to try to stuff out some of the options from Nairo, especially the Nair. It's an incredible move, does pretty much everything you want it to, but the startup is not incredible on it. Oh, no!
Wow, the tether missing the edge, and Nairo letting Mars get back right there, saying, I'm going to keep the ledge traps coming. Forget about taking these risks off stage.
Bit of a misinput right there. You know, Mars was looking for a follow-up out of that Nair at the ledge. See if we can find here now, trying to trap, but Nairo, so aggressive in the air right now. It's really working out for him.
For these down tilts. Great way to catch two frames of Politano without putting your own hurt box at risk. Ooh, Mars with the far throw into the tech chase, not gonna go through, but Nairo in the corner now. Yes, no. Mars able to do it, and the down smash into up B. That boost kick, gonna take care of you for sure, and now we have even stocks. This was a bit one-sided in the beginning, but Mars saying, you know what, I'm not gonna let it go that easily.
Nairo knows the golden rule, do not tech into Mars ever. He's always looking for a down smash or something crazy afterwards, but here we go, trying to recover now. Mars stuck on the ledge. Nairo's been so good here, but Mars able to get out of it that time with a parry, paralyzed it the wrong way though.
And yeah, forget about Mars, don't tech into any Zero Suit.
They're always absolutely looking
you're
for
right.
that.
You're right. He wrote the book on this character, he's gonna keep reading it.
Dash attack so good for Palu, KO option, hard to challenge because of the shield. That just saved him! What a contention from Mars with the Nair. Not enough yet. Okay, he caught him that time. What a snipe from Nairo. Mars was falling so fast right there. What placement of that explosive flame. Really good job. Nairo dictated the pace of that matchup right out of the gate 100%. That was incredible play from the one, the only, Nairo.
All right, let's see. I know Mars is not the type of player to let this loss get to his head, though. He's back so ferocious sometimes. And in the second game, it's going to be his counterpick. Perfect chance to do so. Pokemon Stadium 2 is the selection.
You know what he's gonna do? Change the game plan, not the floor plan. Oh no,
change
he did.
The floor
no,
plan
he's gonna change the floor plan,
plan
and the game plan. I'm sorry, I mixed that one up.
It's all good.
It's still a good one. It's still a good one.
You're just getting used to that saying I came up with. It's okay. Everybody gets to mess it up.
It's a tough one. But here we go. It is going to be game two, stadium two. These guys getting into it. Gamble 2019, game two. Mars Nairo.
And here we go. Nairo drawing first blood with these neutral airs. Wow, trying
Seriously?
To send a message and dunk him. Both of these guys love those crazy, bold offstage plays.
Okay, Nairo, though, I like how he's slowing it down a little bit, getting the reticles going. Very nice. Oh, couple nairs. Oh, he hit that last one? It would have been craziness.
Both of these ladies certified pilots on the nair plane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's a great way to put it. Here we go. Grab. Going to be back throw. Looking for something. He respects Nairo enough not to look for the flip kick cheese right there, so that's good. He knows Nairo knows about it, obviously.
Yeah, these guys definitely respect each other on an individual level, but you see them still make very disrespectful plays.
Ooh, okay. Good job contesting that one from Mars. The quick forward air beating out that forward smash that was starting up from Nairo, and that's going to be the name of the game for Mars, is he's going to need to beat Nairo to the punch a lot, and it's been really hard. Nairo's placement has been incredible between his aerials, his smashes, everything, man. He's just been spacing so well. And this explosive flame, Nairo's getting better and better with it as the set goes on.
This match, not pretty at all. They are slugging each other, and it's going to be Mars taking the first stock. saying, you know what, man, you open with a zero death, that's cool and everything, but I'm going to work this set back into my favor. Down throw from Nairo, of course, knows that he can air dodge from that position at that percent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he got out of there, but oh my God, Nairo was on him, man. He was following him all the way down there. He's like, oh, I see where you're going, man. It's like, where you go, that's where I want to be.
Looking for the chase down with the dash grab. Nairo trying to find any way to seal the deal on this first stock from Mars, but the movement is too crisp. He's going left, he's going right.
Every which way, man, he's jumping in the air. Nairo trying to find maybe, no, he's jumping more and more, looking for a grab. The back throw, super close to doing it, but not quite enough. Mars using the jump. Oh, yeah, Nairo, he knew he didn't have a ton of outs right there. Very good job scoping out Mars all the way at the bottom of the screen.
Yeah, due to the lingering hitbox on that neutral air, drop zoning with it is such a great answer to both Zero Suit's tether recovery and the boost kick. Oh, so unfortunate. No sweet spot on the down B. That certainly would have sent Nairo to an early grave.
Okay, gambles a little bit there with the up B. He's going to pay for it big time here, too. 35 from Nairo, racking it up more, 50, and he kept Mars in the disadvantage, too. That was smooth gameplay from Nairo. I mean, if you get Paolo a layup in terms of a punishment, it's going to be big damage.
Yeah, those low percent combos from her are so devastating. We see Nairo taking a little bit of an adaptation on it. Up air, nair, bear. Crispy stuff.
Even against someone like Mars, who SDIs literally every hit that he can. He doesn't care if it's a one-hit move that does 1%. He's trying to SDI it. His reaction time's that good, and his mashing is that good, too.
Yeah, have you seen the way this kid dash dances?
Yes. Of course, man. Oh, you weren't asking me. You
must need a new controller every week.
Here comes Mars on the hunt, getting aggressive. I like the push away from the auto reticle on Nairo, saying, get away from my ledge. That's mine.
Nairo all of a sudden way back in this. Almost even here, 20% deficit. Ooh,
doink.
Not enough.
Charging stars,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
That's actually you. That is actually you. Looking for the up smash. Look at the spacing by Nairo, though. Getting the back air, weaving around the up smash. Another rising up air. Crowd reacting to that one big time. Mars taking a lead here in game two.
Nairo a little bit scared on the way down. Mars going to take full advantage. Ooh, up smash. Potentially a big opener at 0%. No, but Mars staying all over Nairo right now, keeping the pressure coming. Works into the corner. Pivot grab to keep it going. Ooh, no. The flip kick would have been his stock, but of course, Nairo very, very familiar with this character with and against her.
He literally has an emoji of the flip kick still. That's one of his emojis as a sub, so you gotta look out for that move. But here we go. He's gonna get punished for that one. Looking for the scaredy cat option on the way in. Mars trying to close out this game. He doesn't want to lose the stock, but unfortunately he's gonna whip a grab and lose that stock right as I say that. So here we go. Nairo now on the hunt, trying to take this game two down, but Mars has him a dangerous percentage for sure.
Almost 90% up, man. I'd love to call that extra credit, but he basically aced the class again. Oh, the falling neutral air just pops him up enough to get another one, and a big combo to follow. Almost 50.
You know, up B? Hold on.
Yeah, he's living that one.
Yep, it was close.
If anyone can DI that, it's Nairo.
He better know how to, man. he's on the other end of it now. I know, he's like, wait, how do I do that? What move is that?
Is this what I've been doing to people for years?
You see that recovery? The sneakiest from Nairo. Wow, that was amazing.
Threading the needle.
Oh, and he's got out. Mars in trouble. So much trouble here. What's he going to do? I thought he was going to air dodge. Nothing. Rising up air, though. Oh, no, the whip grab, forward air from Nairo.
Yep, not such a big punish at all. Wow, look at them just missing each other by a hair.
Both these guys trying to avoid each other, trying not to get this last hit on each other. Let's see what we can find. Zare, pressure at the ledge from Mars, looking for the side B. Nice patience by Nairo. What? They just ran up? They just shook hands? That's
it? Throw's coming.
Okay, yeah, with no DI mix-up, okay?
They're running into each other. No kiss.
But he has to grab in order to get that. Max, if he whips a grab, he's done. Nairo's still good at punishing that. Rising up air to catch Nairo. Another one on the other side. Mars, you're a madman taking that game down. Look at that. He popped off a bit, too. We'll get that in the replay, I'm sure. 1-1. Nairo Mars, what a well-fought game two. Mars clutching it out right there. That was crazy. One thing I love, Max, that we're seeing from Mars, and he told me he wanted to do this before the set, is he wants to fight Nairo and he wants to keep him at a disadvantage. That might mean not going for the big swings. He's using his Zare a lot just to push Nairo in the disadvantage, push him towards the ledge, keep him in the disadvantage rather than going for big hits and missing, because you see how well Nairo can reset neutral and then win it afterwards.
Palutena, great character on offense, great character in neutral, but when she's coming down from the skies, that's when you start to see the suffering begin. And that's very smart of Mars. Just go for those juggles, right? Get those up airs, keep repeating them. She's not going to swing too big on you on the way down. It's either a long-lasting neutral air, which you can predict, or down air, which doesn't have the biggest hitbox out there, although it does cover below her.
Right. Tired already, man. This is
a crazy set.
This is,
I know.
How are they doing it? But anyway, it's going to be a best of three now. Nairo's counter pick is what we're going to be working with. It is going to be Town and City. He's going to spread this out a little bit. Talk to Mars. I asked him how he feels about stages. He said the only stages he doesn't like are FD and Kalos.
Interesting. Okay.
So, yeah, he doesn't want it. He wants the platforms, obviously, for Zero Suit. Look how well she moves around them, and he can send his combos on them. But also on Kalos, you can't do Nair Flip Kick because the platforms get in the way.
Right,
yep,
yeah.
Exactly. So you're going to see him ban those two stages for sure. He likes every other stage in this matchup. But I feel like the more real estate you have, the better it is for Nairo because he can do stuff like that. But Zero Suit's so fast, he's going to be able to capitalize, punishing the Radical, getting a Nair and a dunk. We'll be seeing you. Mars going up big. One stock in this game three.
And it's funny because Town and City is somewhat similar to Kalos Pokemon League when the platforms are in that formation, of course, with the addition of the middle one, but they're higher on Town and City than Kalos, so you're going to see the Nair to Flip Kick go through. The Nairo fighting from behind yet again, reminiscent of game two. Oh, but a quick toss!
Yeah, that's so good, man. Something I've been pointing out throughout this tournament is if you pummel, obviously getting percentage is great, but if you catch them snoozing and not having good DI on your throws, throws can kill upwards of 20% earlier, so that's craziness, man. Good catch by Nairo.
Yeah, don't let him react if you don't have to.
Oh, Mars! What a conversion! This is why he likes Town and City. The platforms are still so good for him. The offense off the stage, but on the platform, man, let's see what Mars can find now. Nice dash attack. That was perfect. The double doink.
Another one. Nairo back in it. The shield getting a lot of use.
Okay, Nair catching Mars on the other side. Another. Oh, my goodness. The shield getting the work now.
Oh, did he just footstool him?
He air dodged, and then he was falling down that way. So, yeah, either way, Mars is dropping the stock. Tying it right up. Nairo, he's a responder, man.
My eyes have failed me. I'm sorry, guys.
What an air dodge in for Mars. Going to be able to get a good punish for it too.
Nair, fair, dash attack, keeps the hits coming. These bread and butters from Palutena so destructive, even if they're only a few hits.
Yo, Nair, looking for the flip kick. He finds it, but he bounces him off the stage. Good stuff from Mars. It's good damage, but here comes Nairo again, reestablishing himself in the neutral.
Trying to get that platform tech chase. Nairo just unable to reach Mars, standing his ground with the neutral tech.
Oh, good tricky movement there. After bouncing off the shield, you are vulnerable to Zero Suit, but you can cross him up a little bit. Looking for the up air. What an air dodge from Nairo. The platform coming through for him, too, restoring his recovery resources.
That was a great drift mix-up, too.
Oh, he's living.
Mars hanging on, but not for long. The forward air. That was looking like Zelda out there.
That was looking like a neutral air. It hit in the center of Palutena. What was that hitbox? That was craziness. That's a really weak hit, too. And when he's so close to the blast zone, it didn't matter. Nairo, clutch master in that game three. Wow.
These two are such animals, man, when they get on the sticks.
This is some of the best sets in Smash are these two. I hate complimenting Light, but hopefully he's not watching. No one sent him this, but these two and any combination of these two and Light, those are some of my favorite sets. I also love watching Sam Soren tweak, but like whole different beast when it comes to kind of aggressive play and capitalization while in advantage. These two and Light.
So many amazing players out here in Ultimate. Great game to watch, great game to play. If this is your first time, welcome to the club. And thank you for tuning in, of course, to everybody watching Kamel 2019. We've got game four of Mars versus Nairo, our first side of winner semifinals. Nairo opening up big here on Pokemon Stadium 2. This was Mars' counterpick.
Oh, Nairo just going to take him for a ride. Marvel 2. Oh, my goodness. The platform cancel. Turn around. Auto reticle. Nairo.
Did you see that up smash smack Nairo into the wall, too? That was such a goofy interaction. But these guys, they're going to keep rolling with it. Oh, just the mini spike on that one. The little footstool out of flip jump. No kick.
Mm-hmm. Nairo on the hunt here. Nice. They keep running into each other's shields. I feel like they're trying to scare each other and then react to whatever they're doing afterwards, but both of them are staying so diligent in their shields. Very good work by both these players, man.
It's a game of chicken, but nobody's getting scared. These are two of the bravest players out there.
Nair, back air, great conversion. So much time to do that, man.
Ooh.
Just barely missing the teleport punish. Nice. I like that juke out by Nairo, just going straight ahead. Kind of like that's what the platforms are there for, too. I cannot believe that didn't connect. That is such a big lingering hitbox. Back air, though, good tech chase by Mars.
Nairo with these crazy call outs on the platform. And it's going to be the Plasma Whip taking Nairo off the top. Mars establishing the first stock lead here.
Dude, but this thing between these two guys, the lead almost means nothing. You know what I mean? The other one could just pop off and take a stock in two hits.
Especially with these characters.
Nairo's remembering, it looks like his go-to now, he's more of like a shield and also like a laser character right now. Using the auto reticle and the shield, the back air and dash attack have been so good for him, but he's not able to find them right now. It's Mars' turn to have some offense. Oh, there it is.
Yeah, that back air out of shield, such a dangerous option for Palutena. Also because it blows up block strings. If you try to stick something out, that shield's going to eat right through it, turn your hitbox off. The Mars doesn't care whether his hitboxes are on, off, if they're hitting you or not. He's just all about this pressure, working Nairo to the corner again. Oh, and he still maintains stage control here. Doesn't matter if he doesn't have a great shield grab. My man just dances. He's going to be whiff punishing rather than out of shield.
Mars is going to have to respect Nairo a lot here, especially when he's in the air. Going to be looking for either a nair. Oh! Okay, he goes for a back air instead. Forward air, going to push Mars off the stage. Back air, great trade for Nairo. He had to take some damage to do it, but he had to get that first stock was super pesky for Mars. That kid did not want to die. He didn't want to give that one up.
Mars managing to sneak a hitbox underneath the shield of Palutena. That's one of the few instances you'll see the back air actually trade.
Mm-hmm.
Great aim there.
Okay, all right, I've got to say it. Neutral B between these two characters. Palutena just wins from far away. There's three of them. It's faster, just better from that distance, so.
Yeah, Mars not leading in the projectile war by any means. He's going to take this fight up close and personal. And Nairo working it all the way back. It's almost even. One more hit.
You know what Nairo is so good at, and it shows that he played the character for so long, is he's so good at tracing Zero Suit's recovery and jamming out the down beat from her as a recovery route.
Exactly. That's kind of the level one option, too. You know the Zero Suit's going to be looking for that to get back to the stage. And Nairo covering it so effectively.
Okay, Mars flipping back into the action, literally. Now here we go, down throw. Trying to pin him at the platform. Mars says, no, I'm going to bypass the ledge. What a tricky recovery right there from Mars. Getting two up airs for it, too. For the up smash, trying to get it to tickle beneath the platform. It does not shield poke, though.
I really like that because if Nairo tried to parry the up air, that also would have blown him up.
Okay, Mars looking for a down smash. Oh, nothing there. Nairo going to run up and get a grab. Mars currently on the last, potentially the last stock he has on this winner side of the bracket.
They were all tied up at 135. Two stocks going to beat Nairo, taking the lead. Oh, he's stuck off stage. Oh, a rare directional air dodge. That was certainly an accident, but Mars all over it. Going to pick up an easy punish with up smash. Taking Nairo to his last stock.
Oh my goodness. On the wings of an angel, man. What an extension of that combo. Great recognition from Nairo, but it's now it's Mars' turn to talk. Get off me, though. The auto reticle max has been so good.
That's no angel. That's a goddess. That's a respect on her.
Oh, it's a demon as well.
Bracket demon for sure.
Oh, hold on, though. No. Right now, Mars on the hunt. What a call out there. Catching the teleport. Let's see what Nairo can do now. It's his turn. No, it is not. Mars taking it right back.
And in the absence of Zero Suit's ladder combos into boost kick, you're going to see him use that up air for juggles over and over again. It's a good move. Covers all around her. Doesn't send you too far. Just far enough that you have to think about how you're going to get back
down. All the way to the top, the reverse hit of up air. Mars, you're a madman.
Hey, man, just as I was saying, it's not that strong of a move in terms of raw knockback. When you're up there, it doesn't matter. You can get sneezed on, and that's the end of you.
If you're touching the blast zone, anything will kill, basically. And that up air, that was crazy. I love the way he positioned himself, too, because if you're facing backwards like that, everyone in the venue is thinking he's looking for a back air. He's looking for a back air. No, Mars goes with a very, very quick and upwards hitting hitbox right there. It was nuts with the up air. What a crazy mix-up. What a call-out on one of the best players in the world, Nairo. Game 5, Max. Game 5.
Could you ask for a better set?
Let's see how it ends.
These guys are winners bracket for a reason.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, same, dude. I was just about to do the same thing, but I don't want to steal your thunder. This is just such a winding top eight, man. There's so many good matches to be played, so many left. This is only our third set out of basically the 10 that we're going to see in the top eight.
Right. Zero Suit Samus, Palutena. It's becoming a classic.
It is, and Mars is really the main Zero Suit Samus out there, right? We saw Nairo, Mars, and a whole bunch of other ones under them, right?
Choco.
Pretty popular character. Yeah, it's Choco, of course. Yeah. I've got a shout out Exodia from Canada as well.
All right, fair enough. Let's go. Okay, hold on. Nairo starting it off with another Nair. Looking for forward air follow up, too, but here we go. Nairo doing a great job controlling the tempo of this. No. He's going to need an up smash for that one and into an up air, too. Nairo landing, though. Defensive Nair on the way down. Up to a good lead here.
Going to see that forward air from Mars trying to shake some of the pressure from Nairo here, but not enough. That move, a bit unreliable in the way that the two hits link into each other.
Mm-hmm. Mars, I love the way he's delaying these up airs and catching Nairo. Nairo again, another miss input. That's two so far this game. I don't think you can get away with many, many more. Okay, parry on the Nair. You can't punish it, though, from that distance.
Such a back and forth here in this fifth game.
What?
Whoa,
what?
Falling out of the plasma whip and directional air dodging right to the ledge. I don't think that's what Nairo is looking for.
Is that like a weird windbox type thing? That was the craziest hit of that. But either way, Nairo cleaning up the stock. Back air.
Nairo, that's Mars.
Oh, sorry,
baby.
Mars. I was thinking of Nairo because I was thinking of the plasma whip is throwing me up, man. That was the weirdest hit I've ever seen it get. But either way, Mars continuing the offense here with a parry of his own.
back air, fighting his way back down to the ground. Nairo looking for these nairs out of shield, but Zero Suit is just so mobile, it's hard to actually get a hit to respond to her pressure.
Yeah, Nairo trying to mix up the tempo here. He goes, you know what, I don't have the lead, but I can kind of play like it anyway. I'm going to reestablish myself on the ground, try to force something bad out of Mars. But that, what an explosive flame there. Didn't love the second one, but he's set up for a dash attack. Good stuff from Nairo.
Just taking these landing options away from Mars bit by bit. Now he just needs to land a good, clean hit, but you know who knew that needed to happen as well? My man Mars.
Oh, look at the Zeri setting him up. He wants to put him in an unfamiliar situation and punish him for a bad choice, but Nairo's not biting. Oh, no.
That could have been huge, and so could that up air from Nairo.
What is happening right now? I've not seen Nairo play like this before. This is definitely, I don't know, man. He's got to buckle down if he wants to take this game in the set, Max.
I say if he takes the second stock or the first stock from Mars before going to the triple digits, he's still in a good place. And he is only 83 if you're rounding up.
He's fine, man. He's totally fine. You can definitely make this happen, and this is the way to get it going. What a party starter that Nair is. Almost 30% off of it. Very good stuff, Nairo. He has pinned at the ledge, too.
Yeah, couldn't link the third one, but it doesn't matter. He'll take the control that it comes with. Ooh, Zer, though, one of the few things Zero Suit has to truly outrange and contend with Palutena's buttons. Hey, man, she's a really good character, right? A little Freudian slip
there. What a conversion we're talking about, Bayonetta. Mars is taking stocks. Very nice job. Nairo, now he's on the end of having only maybe his last winner's stock left, man. He was looking for the instant flip right there, and Mars not biting.
Nairo dropping that punish on the flip jump footstool, but it doesn't matter. He's still in a great position, holding the stage control. Gets a ledge trap situation, but no, Mars able to stand up in between the hits of the Nair. Lock the last one. Nairo with a punish.
It's scary because, the explosive flame. Not enough yet. Let's see what he can find. Nope, Mars going high. Very, very smart stuff. Nairo's been a beast off stage in the set.
Nairo going real high for the chase too. Not going to pan out though.
It's so scary because Nairo, if he wants to retreat, he has to go off stage, which is where Mars wants him. He wants to hit an air flip kick and walk away clean.
Oh, that was pixels away from being the end of the set, but Nairo with a second lease on life here. What's he gonna do with it?
Mars just turned around there. He didn't really do a whole lot. I think he was trying to throw up his shield again, but it didn't work. Now he's looking for the side B. It does connect. Looking for a back air too, getting aggressive himself. Mars poised to take the set right now. Nairo trying to find an answer. Mars,
he missed the angle.
Well, you hate to see it happen, but you know, Mars is still feeling really good, of course. I mean, let's be real for a second. There's what, 12 stocks that Mars had to take throughout that, right? No, did he have to win four? No,
15.
No,
there are five games.
He had to win three, though.
Oh, okay.
So he had to take 9 stocks. So he earned 8 of them clean. And he put a lot of pressure on Nairo in that situation, kind of forced him to recover poorly. It wasn't an unforced error. It wasn't like he just, SD'd from center stage. So it's kind of a wet firecracker there. And